Hi, would you like to learn how to talk about age in English? Welcome to Jen's Jyugyou. My name is Jen, and today you're going to learn some useful vocabulary and grammar tips to help discuss age in English. When we are talking about age, we are asking about how old someone is. We don't usually ask this question to adults in Canada because it can be seen as very rude. However, if we want to know the age of a child, for example, it is very common to ask, "How old are you?" Or, "How old is he? How old is she?" Notice that we are using the be verb. The be verb in the simple present is am, are, is. The reason why we need to use the be verb is because age is describing someone. Age is an adjective. Adjectives have to come after the be verb or before a noun. A noun means a person, place, animal, or thing. Using the be verb, we can make sentences such as, he is 5 years old. She is 12 years old. They are 6 years old. As I mentioned, someone's age is an example of an adjective, and we can put adjectives before nouns. When we use age in this way, we will put a hyphen between the number, years, and old. There will be two hyphens. His 95-year-old grandfather fought in World War II. A quick point about using adjectives in this way is to make sure you don't add an S to the end of the word year. Adjectives cannot be made plural. There can never be S's on the ends of adjectives. His 5-year-old son likes spaghetti. My 7-year-old cousin is fluent in English and Japanese. When someone has a birthday, they become older. When someone is becoming older, we can use the verb turns to describe their age changing from one age to another. My neighbor turns 5 next week. Last month, his cousin turned 12. If we are discussing an adult's age, we might not know their exact age since we don't usually ask about age in English. So we can say that someone is in there, and then we use numbers ending in zeros. For example, she is in her 20s. He is in his 40s. They are in their 60s. If we have a little bit more of an idea of the person's age, we can also add the adjectives early and late in front of the numbers. For example, he is in his early 20s. She is in her late 70s. Another expression you might hear when talking about age is the expression, oh, they are 30-something, he's 50-something. We're using the word something at the end of the number ending in zero because we're not sure about the adult's exact age. He's 20-something is the same as saying he's in his 20s. More casually among native speakers, you might also hear the expression ish, I-S-H, added to the end of numbers ending in zero to describe the person's age. So he is 30-something, he is in his 30s, or he's 30-ish. When we use ish, it could mean higher or lower than the actual number we are saying. If there's a person we think, maybe they are in their late 30s, maybe they're in their early 40s, I'm not sure, we would usually just say, that person is 40-ish. Using ish is very casual among native speakers, but this expression should not be used in formal situations. Next, I want to take a look at some English vocabulary words that we use to discuss people's ages, specific words. We have the expression a baby. Usually, a baby is considered anywhere from the time the child is born up until around 3 years old, we can still call that child a baby. If the baby was recently born and is maybe only a few weeks or maybe 1 or 2 months old, we can call them a newborn. Newborn can be a noun. Oh, look at the picture of the adorable newborn. Or it can also be an adjective. Her newborn baby is adorable. Another word you might hear to discuss very, very young children is infant. Infant is another word that we can use for babies, especially very young babies. When a child is around 2.5, 3 years old and they start walking, we use the expression toddler. So a toddler is a young child around 2, 3, 4 years old. You have to keep a careful eye on toddlers because they can get into trouble easily. A child is any type of kid is another word that we use. Person who is between the ages of 0 and usually up to 12 or 13 years old, we can call them a kid or a child. Remember that child is an irregular noun. If you have more than one child, it is children. When someone is between the ages of 13 and 19, they are called a teenager. So this is because their age is in the teens. So if they are 13, 14, 15, 16, etc., they are called a teenager. Being a teenager is very difficult these days. When someone officially becomes an adult, we can say that they have reached the age of majority. In Canada, someone is officially and legally considered an adult once they become 18 years old. Once you turn 18, you are an adult in Canada. In English, we have a unique expression for people who are around ages 45 to 65. In between that age group, we might hear the expression middle-aged. Oh, they are a middle-aged person. The middle-aged woman in front of me at the grocery store took a long time counting out her change. Middle-aged. And this is also connected to an English expression you might have heard called a midlife crisis. A midlife crisis is usually when someone reaches around age 40, 45, and they start thinking, oh my goodness, what have I done with my life? I'm getting older, my life is half over, what have I accomplished? And they start worrying about things like that. When they are middle-aged, they will have a midlife crisis. When someone has reached age 65 or older, they are considered to be a senior. You might also hear the expression senior citizen. So a senior or a senior citizen is someone who is older than 65 years old. People who are seniors are obviously older members of society. But in English, it's very rude to call a person old when they are advanced in years. Instead, a positive adjective with the same meaning as old that we use to talk about older people is elderly. The elderly man used his cane while crossing the street. The elderly woman needed new glasses. Saying elderly is much more polite than old. If you don't want to be polite when discussing an elderly person's age, and instead you don't mind sounding a little bit rude or having a little bit of fun with a close friend, I want to teach you two expressions that are used to talk about people who are older. The first expression is often used to people in their 40s to make fun of them for getting older, but is traditionally used to talk about someone who is in their mid to late 50s or 60s. The expression is over the hill. To be over the hill means that you are quite elderly, you are old. If you describe someone as over the hill, it is very negative and can be seen as a little bit rude. But if you say it about yourself, if you are older, then it can sound kind of
funny and humorous.
Specifically, to be over the hill means that you are no longer young and as a result are no longer able to do the things that you were once able to do. Another English expression used in a similar way to be over the hill is to say that someone is no spring chicken. No spring chicken. For example, if my husband does something that makes me think, wow, my goodness, he's getting old, he needs special bifocal glasses now, I might say, wow, look at your bifocals, you're no spring chicken, are you? This expression is used to make fun of someone who's getting older. But of course, people can also use it about themselves as well. What? You want me to run 10 kilometers with you? I'm no spring chicken, you know. We could describe someone as being young at heart. Young at heart means that regardless of their actual age, they still have a very youthful and joyful spirit. They're still able to enjoy and think about the things that they like to do and imagine that they are still young even if their body is not. Before my elderly aunt passed away, she still had such a great joy for living and experiencing new things. She was very young at heart. So today, you learn lots of useful grammar and vocabulary to help talk about age in English. And now it's time for Question of the Day. Today's question is, in your life so far, what has been your favorite age and why? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching this lesson. If you found it useful, please subscribe to Jen's Jyugyou and give this video a thumbs up. Good luck with your English studies. See you in the next lesson.